Ben from Stoneys here, folks, today with the Gasmate Voyager BBQ. This is a gourmet camping solution for your campsite. It's an affordable alternative to a Weber barbecue and is still lightweight and compact for transport. And the Voyager's got a very similar configuration to the popular Weber BBQ or Family Q barbecues. They're a really good barbecue, don't get me wrong, but they're also quite expensive, and this offers a really affordable alternative for campers and also a much lighter weight alternative for transport. Now, I'll start off with some of the boring bits. It weighs around about 9 kilos. It measures about 48 centimeters from the lid, the end of the lid to the lid here. If you include the handles, it goes out to about 56 centimeters. But if you want to allow space to sort of store it with this hose attached, you probably want to allow 65 centimeters of length this way. And then if we go depth wise, it's around about 37 centimeters sort of from on the lid here, 37-38 centimeters. And then if you add the handle into that, it's about 40 centimeters in width. And regarding height, as it sits here at the moment, it's about 36-30 centimeters high. It's hard to get an exact measurement. If you want space for this lid to open up underneath something, you do need ventilation above it. That goes up to about 65 centimeters. And it also collapses down for transport a little bit. So these legs underneath here fold flat like this. If you fold it flat and slide it into your car, it's about 27-28 centimeters height to this point here, but that's as much as it will pack up. You can potentially take the hose off the end here. You'd have to unscrew it from here, but you're not going to gain a lot of storage space by removing that, and you'd need a spanner to do it up each time. The body of the barbecue, the Voyager, is made of a powder-coated steel. So all this black shiny coating here is a powder-coated steel. The handles are a heat-resistant handle. There's three handles like this, and the brackets are all a metal bracket as well. If we do a bit of a tour around the outside, we'll start with the front here, just a handle to lift the lid, and two latches here that do have a little kind of hole in there, so you could lock it if you want. I'm not sure what you'd be locking inside your barbecue. If we flip it around to this end here, I'll just hold it up to show you that there's not much to see here. We've got another handle on the side here and the folding leg on the bottom here. Looking at the back, once again, not a lot to see other than the hinges, which are just a pin that goes through the hinges here to hold it in place, and the lid pivots on that. And then at this end here, we have another handle, plastic handle. Below that, the flame control, which also contains a rotary piezo igniter, so you don't need a match or a flame to light this. It's all incorporated into that. We'll fire it up shortly. And that leads to a hose. Now, this hose is about 90 centimeters. This black section here is 90 centimeters plus this section here. And it has a POL attachment on the end here with a regulator included. So that will go to an LPG bottle. In this instance, we've got a little 3/8 BSP bottle with a POL adapter on it. So that will go straight into the POL adapter, or you can use a large 9 kilo cylinder where this goes straight into it. Now, one cool feature is the little thermometer in the lid here. So as with Weber barbecues, you cook with the lid down, you can monitor how hot it is inside. This has got a little thermometer on top there, which has got a little sensor inside underneath the lid here, which obviously picks up the temperature inside here, and you can monitor how hot things are cooking. Now, this isn't a really thick lid like the Weber barbecues, which have got a thick alloy lid. This is just a sheet metal here. So I guess that's one of the things to make it a far more affordable a barbecue. So it's not going to retain the heat quite as well. You might use a bit more gas to retain the heat inside. But if we have a look at the features inside here, what you do have is a enamel cast iron cooking surface here. So you've got this is just a hot plate on this side here and a grill plate on this side here, and your total cooking area is about 46 centimeters in length from end to end here and about 33 centimeters in depth. Now, you can't buy different plates to go in here, and they do actually recommend that you probably keep one of these grills in here anyway, just to allow the airflow. If you put another hot plate on this side, you're kind of limiting that flow from top to bottom and you're not benefiting from the lid. But these do come out, so we can pull these aside and put them out just to clean inside of here. We can see that underneath that we've got a steel, this is all metal as well, steel burner. We'll light this up shortly to show you what it looks like. And there's the piezo igniter there. And you've got holes in the bottom here just to allow airflow up underneath and through the lid. And they work with the vents in the back of the lid here as well to allow that airflow through it to get that kind of convection cooking sort of feature happening. And then one other thing in the bottom here is a little hole at the front here, which is a little fat dripping point. So if this does happen to fill up in fat down here, that lines up with a little tray that slots in underneath here. It's a little metal tray, so not huge. You probably want to empty this after cooking a good barbecue, but that's going to catch all the fats and oils rather than it dripping on top of your table. While we're on the topic of tables, you probably can use this on top of a cooking surface because you've got this sort of clearance here. I don't know what that is, probably sort of 14, 15 centimeters of clearance there. So you do have a bit of height difference, but always be wary of just how hot it is getting underneath here. If it is a sensitive table that you're cooking on, then you probably want to put something in between it, but much higher than most barbecues will offer or stoves will offer from the tabletop. It's probably important to note that these can't be reversed. They are slightly, they're not symmetrical in shape, so you're going to have to keep your grill plate on the right hand side and your hot plate on the left hand side as such. And you can cook as you do with Weber's with the lid down in this, so you get that convection cooking thing going on, or cooking roasts. And you've got, when this is down, you've got about 14 centimeters in height from this cooking surface here to the top of the lid here, just bearing in mind that the little thermometer does stick down a little bit there. So you can cook a reasonable sized roast in your campsite. Now, it probably is important to mention that when you buy these stoves, they come in a somewhat disassembled manner, and there's a little bit of mucking around with nuts and bolts to put it together. It's not difficult. It's all spelled out in the user manual. It's just packed up so that it will fit inside of its box for transport. Putting it together is pretty straightforward. Some things are already attached. Most of it is just a nut bolt and a washer to put things together. Follow it step by step. It's nice and easy. Now I'm going to fire this up, show you how it lights and how the burner looks when it's cooking. And this is a regulated system. So the hose that comes with this has the regulator on it. We need to supply regulated gas supply into this burner here. So if we want to connect this to a caravan, we need to remove this hose. This is a 3/8 SAE fitting to the burner here. And we need to replace this hose with a 3/8 SAE to bayonet fitting. So that then connects to the regulated gas supply on your caravan. In this instance though, we're going to leave the regulator in the system because we have an unregulated supply coming from the gas canister here. So I'm going to screw this on, and as always, I'll check for leaks and make sure there's no gas leaks here. And always be wary when you're using gas that there's no smell of gas or anything around. Now, lighting this is pretty straightforward. I'm going to take these hot plates off of here so you can see the stove lights. Now, be wary when you're lighting this, especially from new, that you need to let gas come through the hose here and into the burner here. So don't hold down on it too long. And if you start to smell gas from where you're standing, you probably just need to let it clear a bit before you try and light it. So to light it, once the gas is on at the bottom, we come to the control knob here and we push this in and turn it. When we turn it, the piezo igniter inside is going to spark, and it's not necessarily going to light the first time because we need to allow time for the gas to come through the hose here and to the burner. So if it doesn't light the first time, and it did that time, if it doesn't, turn the control knob off again and keep trying until it does light. If you get to the point where you've tried it a number of times and you're starting to smell gas, maybe just leave it sit for a while until the gas clears and try again, because you've got this kind of thing here that's catching gas inside of it. You don't want that to kind of fill up with gas. So just be wary when you're lighting it. But once gas is actually in the hose, it lights really quick and easy. So when you light it, it goes straight to high. So that's on the highest setting there at the moment. It's 11,000 BTU burner. Gas consumption or energy consumption is 12 millijoules per hour. So if I hold my hand up like this, I can feel it reasonably warm about here. It's not a big hot 25,000 BTU burner like a lot of camp stoves are, but it's not designed as such. It's designed to have a nice flat cooking surface here for your barbecue or your meat. And then you can close the lid to trap that warmth in so you get an even cooking of the heat. That's on high at the moment. As this is, you can't turn that off without pushing it in. But if I spin it around this way, we can see the flame dies right down to quite low. And if I put my hands above that now, I can get it right down to here, and that's feeling warm at the moment, so that would be enough just to sort of keep things warm. Or you've got to remember that once you've cooked for a while, and with the cooking plates being cast iron, these heat up and retain a lot of heat. So if you turn it up high to start with, warmed these up, and then turned that down, it's going to retain a lot of heat in this cooking surface. So you don't need a super hot burner in this stove here. You just kind of need even heat to be able to cook the meat by. Now, turning the barbecue off is nice and easy. We spin this around to high, and it doesn't go all the way off until you push it in. So push it in a little bit and turn the rest of the way, and the gas ignites at the burner there. Now, cleaning the stove is pretty easy inside here. I probably wouldn't recommend using high pressure water or anything, but certainly use hot soapy water inside, and it's going to be able to drip out the little drip hole there, either into the drip tray underneath or just straight out to the floor below. And cleaning of the hot plates here, treat these like you would say cast iron, where you want to season the cooking surface on top here. So when you get a nice sort of oily surface burnt onto this, you don't want to scrub that off. So you really just want to use mild soapy water to give that a clean. Try not to submerge them. Just give it a wipe, pretty much like you would with your barbecue at home. One other thing to mention, a lot of people ask, can I run this on natural gas? The answer is no. You've got to stick with LPG with this guy here. So LPG bottle, like we've set it up on here, or the LPG supply from your caravan. In terms of transport, once you've got this folded up and latched up, there are various bags. There's duffel bags and things that fit. Blacksmith Camping Supplies have made a nice heavy duty canvas bag here specifically for the Gasmate Voyager BBQ here. So that's going to protect it a little bit in the back of your car. That is the Gasmate Voyager BBQ. Awesome alternative to the really well-renowned Weber barbecues. Comes at a portion of the price and it's a little bit lighter to transport. Check them out online at snowys.com.au where you find them at our lowest prices every day. But if you do have any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all the latest information, or check out some other videos like these ones down here.